Hello and welcome to the ME7 Podcast Christmas Quiz. Got the 1893 show helping us out today. A couple of contestants. So, what's going on today is, you don't know me, I'm Kyle. I don't normally feature on the podcast, but I've written the quiz for the guys and I'll be hosting it. And I've got 40 questions for these guys. They've got to get them right. And if they get them wrong, they don't win. And if they give really bad answers, they'll be drinking as punishment. We'll go around and introduce everyone. I'm sure you know James and Owen, but feel free to introduce yourselves, guys.
I'd like to think some of them know me, to be honest.
Well, yeah, you're a regular feature, aren't you?
Occasionally. I'm the one that loves Rubik Kenzie.
I've just introduced myself with a bottle of dark rum, which is probably the start of the evening, isn't it?
I'm putting you
too,
don't you worry.
There we go. Oh, the host is joining as well. What have you got, Alex? What have you got?
I have got some of the finest Smirnoff of vodka, because that's all I had in the draw.
Fair enough. You got Beth?
Unfortunately, I still have to go to work tomorrow, and I'm a teacher, so I can't drink. Since Alex and I are the 1893 show together, anytime I give a stupid answer, he can drink for me.
Okay, well, he's been dropped in now. Right. Let's get going. Question one. In what year did the club change their name from New Brompton FC to Gillingham FC?
What year? Oh my god. It's not that though. Oh, it might be that.
Okay, right. We'll start with Owen.
Well, I know we're, in terms of when Jules, I'd say 1893, but I feel like that would be too obvious a trick question. So I think
unless
it's
your first answer, you can't change it now.
Yeah, and it's not.
Well, I just said I'll go with it.
That is incorrect. Hawko, what do you think?
Yeah, I've messaged you 1893, but you've just said it's incorrect. So
it is. Alex, what do you answer?
1918.
That's also incorrect, but we do have a correct answer. What is it, Beth?
1912, and the only reason I went for that is it's because the year the Titanic sunk, isn't it? So,
oh, sorry, it was a shot in the dark. You just threw a dart, and it happened to be right.
Kyle, you've given the point to the wrong person, though.
Yeah, I know. It's the scores the wrong way around.
I'll take the point.
Okay, question two. In 1937, Gillingham were voted out of the Football League after finishing bottom 3 years in a row. What team took their place?
Oh my god. How long we got?
How long you got? About 5 seconds.
Oh my god, I don't know. That. It's not that. It's not that. I don't know. Literally.
Okay, let's
send an answer.
Owen, what do you think?
Oldham.
Okay. Alex, what do you think?
Warsaw.
Beth, what do you think?
I went Ipswich.
And Hawker, what do you think?
I've said Halifax, but it's not Halifax.
We actually have someone who got it right. And it's Beth again.
No way.
No way. Listen.
No way.
What is going on here?
I'm too cold with it, me.
Question number three. Who was chairman before Paul Scally?
Name.
Fuck knows.
Oh, yeah, I've got it.
I'm just going to pour a drink ready for that.
Okay. Owen, what's your guess?
I can't remember his name, but if I say a better bloke, that is technically the right answer.
Sure, sure. You're not getting a point for it, though. Alex, what do you think?
Me.
Sure. Were you alive then?
No, I wasn't. I didn't know an answer, and I've already poured the drink out for that one. That's
cool.
So,
Hawker, what do you think, mate?
I've said Tony Smith.
It's a good answer. It's not right, though. Beth, what do you think?
Oh, no.
I didn't know, so I just put John Akinde.
Was it a penalty?
Yeah.
No, the answer is Bernard Baker. I didn't expect anyone to get that one right.
Was
Question
it?
Four. Whose head looks uncannily like the London Planetarium?
Oh.
What's the London Planetarium?
It's what Madame Tussauds in London is now.
Right, okay.
Okay, Beth, do you want to start?
I didn't know, so I went for John Akinde.
Okay, cool. Alex?
Owen?
Hawkeye?
Yeah. Owen Stanley.
Owen, what do you think it is?
Josh Parker.
No, you're all wrong. It's actually Brian Moore. That was what the fanzine that used to be Jules was called. It was Brian Moore's head looks like London Planetarium.
Gross.
Thought you'd all know that. I genuinely thought that was a free hit.
Oh.
Question five. We've won two league titles in our history. One was in 2012-13 season. What season was the other?
Oh.
Okay, Owen, what do you reckon?
1964-65.
Okay, Beth, what do you think?
Oh, I just put 1964. I forgot to put the season.
So I'll say 63-64 for that. Porco?
Sure. I'll put 1903.
And Alex?
78-79.
I don't know how, but Beth's actually got it right again. 63-64.
Kyle.
Yeah. Did I say 64-65?
You did. You hit the post.
Kyle, can I pull up a discrepancy for the Paul Scally question, please?
Yeah.
You on about the man that sold it to Paul Scally?
I'm going by the Wikipedia list of who it said the chairman was.
Man who sold it to Paul Scally was a Mr. Tony Smith.
Okay. Would you like a point for it?
Would like a point for it, please.
That's a shame.
Oh, no!
Question six. Which permanent manager has had the highest win rate of the Scally and post-Scally era?
Oh. Highest win rate. Highest win rate. For them? Him?
Go on, Owen, what do you think?
I think Martin Allen's too obvious. I'm actually going to go with Justin Edinburgh.
Okay. Hawkeye?
I'm going to go Steve Evans.
Beth?
I've gone for Martin Allen.
And Alex?
I've also gone for Martin Allen.
The answer is going to shock all of you. It's actually Peter Taylor. When you combine all of his spells, he still comes just ahead of Tony Pulis and then Martin Allen third.
See, I was thinking about managers who've had two spells, but I was gonna lean more to Lovell in that sense.
Quite a close one, really. I think it was like one win between Taylor, Pulis, and then like two between Pulis and Allen. I've got 43.6, 43.1, and 42.1. So it's very close between all of them. Question seven. Who scored the winning goal in our 5-4 home victory over Hereford in the 11-12 season? In what is possibly the most League Two goal of all time?
Winner.
I'm actually going to get
the winning goal, yeah.
Winning goal.
I'm like toying between two people and I cannot remember for the life of me which one it was.
I think I might actually get a point.
I'll tell you all the goal scorers if you want.
Of course you will.
We don't like Charles here.
And the Hereford ones.
Go on, Owen, talk us through it then, if you reckon you can do that.
I can tell you that our goals were Kepwell, Charlie Lee got two, Chris Welpdale got one, and I'll just give my answer now, because it is on Pat's side. Gavin Tomlin scored the winner.
That is correct. I see all of you put that apart from Alex.
You threw me off from League Two goal. I thought centre half. It's got to be an header. You know what I mean?
Nah, it was the most scabby League Two goal you'll ever see in your life.
Been robbed.
Gavlar.
Yeah. Question 8. Who assisted Simeon Jackson's goal in the 08-09 playoff final win over Shrewsbury?
Who assisted?
Jackson, we all know Jackson scored the header. Who teed it up for him?
Now we're cooking.
Now we are cooking.
Is on. It's red hot.
We're not cooking. I was literally 8 years old.
I've got it right.
Right, go on then, Alex, because your answer's interested me.
Fucking blue, mate. What's his name? Dennis Ollie?
Okay, sure.
Just gone with it. I've gone with it, all right?
He was in the team. He was in the team that day.
Smashed it.
And Beth, what's your answer?
I went for Alex.
He's not far off, all right?
Okay, and I'm sure the other two, if you've got it right.
Josh, all right.
Right.
Yep.
Alex, we stink.
You're winning.
You're still winning.
I was going to say. You're not pointless, though.
Beth, how do you not know that? But you know all the questions from about 1912.
I don't know.
I probably
read a book.
Question 9. Who is the only player to appear in a World Cup finals match while still playing for the club?
Oh, it's one of two.
Oh, no.
I don't know which one.
Oh, no. Who is it? I know the country.
Yeah, I know the country. I just don't know which one of the two it was.
Oh. I'm going to go that one.
Okay, right, let's start. Owen, who is it?
I would say, if it's not this person, I know who it is, but I'd say Brent Sancho.
All right. Alex?
Oh, I'm in Lingansi.
Beth?
I didn't know, so I just went for Simeon Jackson.
Have Canada ever qualified for a World Cup?
Probably not.
Porco, what do you go with?
I've gone Brent Sancho.
It was Brent Sancho, yeah. Obviously, the other option
was... Yeah, I thought it was either him or Kelvin Jack, wasn't it? The keeper.
No, Ian Cox went. Kelvin Jack didn't go, Ian Cox went, but he didn't get off the bench. But Sancho also scored in the wrong net.
Was that against England? So we were in the group, weren't we? Or were we?
Okay. Yeah, it was. Question 10. Oh, go on, Owen.
No, I just said it was 2006. Carry on.
It was, yeah. 10. Who has earned the most international caps whilst playing for Gillingham?
I'm going to go him.
I actually don't even know where to start with a guess.
Okay, Owen, who do you think?
I think this one might be Jackson, just because of this. I can't imagine there's many great Canadian strikers at the time.
True. I see Beth's gone the same with Jackson. Alex, what do you think?
Well, now I think about it, I probably should have gone Jackson, but I went Lingansi again.
Okay, Jackson wasn't correct, actually. Hawko, who was it?
Andrew Cross.
It was Andrew Cross. He got 16. Whilst playing for Jills, yeah. Okay, now...
Was that 16?
He got 16 whilst playing for Jills, yeah, for Wales. I mean, you know, again, another country like Canada, isn't it? It's not too hard. Okay, we've got a little bit of a music round now, and I'm going to hope that this comes across. Okay, this is the first question. I just want to know what the title of the song is.
Thank you.
I can't hear it.
Yeah.
No.
Sing it.
Sing it.
Okay, well, we ain't got time. We'll cut this section out. Question 16. Which club is the furthest away as the crow flies that Jules have had to travel to play in a league match?
And I get well, this season, I just in general. On what?
In the club's history at any point. But it's in the league match.
Can I get clarification on what as the crow fly means?
Basically, like, don't follow Google Maps. It's like just a straight line from our stadium to their stadium.
Okay.
Just gone with the most obvious.
No,
to be
it's
honest.
Wrong.
Yeah, same.
Fuck. I know it is.
Owen, who is it?
Carlisle, because they're basically by Scotland.
James, who is it?
I'll say Carlisle.
Beth, who is it?
I also went for Carlisle.
Alex, who is it?
I put Carlisle, but I've got a feeling it's not.
No, it is Carlisle.
Is it?
It is Carlisle, you're all right. Breathe a sigh of relief.
I knew you said Barrow, to be fair.
I knew you said Hartlepool. I thought he was trying to trick us.
Nah. But Alex, you're off the mark now. You've got a point.
I'm on.
17. How many goals did we score last season?
Like two.
Goals did we score?
Yeah, just how many goals did we score in the league?
If we're all wrong, are you going to give it to the closest two?
Yeah, sure, why not? Oh, and how many do you think?
29.
Okay. Hawko?
35.
Alex?
23.
That's really pessimistic, mate. Beth, how many do you think?
Hey, we scored 9 before Christmas, like, or something like that, weren't it? So.
I went 32.
Hawko was closest. The answer is 36, so it's only one off.
Come on.
It's not too bad. 18. Which players had the most non-consecutive playing spells for us? As in, they have played for us, they have gone to another club, and then they've come back, and then gone to another club, or maybe some more, and come back. So the player I'm thinking of here has basically left. He's played for us on 4 different occasions. So he's played for us, left, come back, left, come back, left, and come back.
When you say he left, like, he...
His contract expired, or he... I don't think he was ever here on loan, so I'm pretty sure all 4 times were separate full-time contracts.
Okay.
Oh, that might have bowled me answer up now, then.
Mine's definitely wrong, but I'm okay with it.
Yeah, mine's definitely going to be wrong.
I'll double check it. I'm pretty sure none of them were loan spells. No, none of them were loan spells.
I can only think of someone who's left once, so I'm just going to go with that.
Okay, Beth, who do you think it was then?
I just went for Max Aymar.
Owen, who do you think?
I was going to say Cody, but I think he came back in the title winning season on loan, didn't he? So I'll go with Max as well.
Hawkeye?
Yeah, I said Ollie Lee, but I don't think it is that.
Alex?
Mine's wrong, but it's my boy, so I don't care. Robin McKenzie.
The answer is actually Nicky Southall. He had 4 different spells at the club.
Oh.
Wasn't too sure if you'd know that, but I mean, he is one of Mr. Gillingham, really, isn't it? The amount of times he's come back
here. I think people are going to scream at us for that one.
Someone is definitely like breaking their computer screen right now. Screaming the answer.
19. In 1995-96 season, Gillingham set the record for the fewest goals conceded in a 46-game season in the Football League. How many goals did we concede in total in league matches only?
Do you know this one? Because Alex and I did a quiz question on it.
I don't know this one, so this makes me look really bad, doesn't it?
Alex does not know it.
Least amount of goals.
Oh no!
This is still a standing record. This is still the fewest goals conceded in a 46-game Football League season.
We hold it.
We still hold it now, yeah.
I how the hell do we hold it?
Need a guess from you, mate.
I'm going that.
Cool. Owen, how many do you think it was?
18.
Okay. Hawko?
I've gone 13.
Alex?
11.
And Beth?
I'm unsure if it's 19 or 20, but I've put 20.
And you'd be correct, it is 20.
Sure, much attention I paid on it.
We definitely spoke about this last year, Alex.
And that record still stands to this day. Following on from that question, how many clean sheets did Jim Stannard, who was our first choice keeper that season, keep? In the league?
Just in that season, whole career.
Just in that season, and only in league matches.
It's got to be higher. Damn that.
Very high, yeah.
Owen, what do you reckon?
23.
Beth?
I've put a stupid answer and I now realise how stupid it is. I put 11, which mathematically makes no sense.
True, at least you've realised that.
Yeah.
28.
Alex?
26.
Hawko was closest. The answer is 29. So do we think we give him a point? I think I will.
Absolutely not.
I think I will.
Yeah, because you won me over on that scully. And Alex also needs to drink for best stupid answer of 11.
The worst part is that I'm a maths teacher, so...
You said Owen Stanley for one of the answers. Get that drink down, son.
It's valid.
Did so you also answer Owen?
It's a true. Very big, big shot.
So Owen's family.
21. What is the most common colour that Jules have used for their away kits since 1980? So we're not counting third kits, it's just away kits.
And that.
You said that again, please.
Didn't help actually, our club colours.
Yeah, so what's the most common colour that Gillingham have used for away kits since 1980? So it's just the away kit. Any third kit we have isn't counted in this.
It's about time we go back to this colour as well.
What do you think, Owen?
I think it's white, but I'm going to say yellow.
Okay. Hawko? Beth?
Yeah, I put yellow as well.
Alex?
What?
You're actually all wrong.
Is it red?
It's red.
Oh.
Yeah.
Red. I've got it here. It was out of 43 seasons, we've actually had our away kit be red 22 times, so it is over half.
Oh, okay.
So it's very common.
We are going to get battered by our older fan base, by the way, on this
100%. Case. I'm so for it.
Yeah, I'm ready for it.
Who was the youngest player to make a first-team appearance for Gills? So, obviously, at the time they appeared, not right this moment, their current age.
This is all competitions?
In all competitions. Pre-season friendlies don't count, but any competitive match, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, Owen, what do you think?
Luke Freeman.
Alex, what do you think?
I can't remember his first name, but it was Khalifi from the title winning season.
Beth, what do you think?
Nathan Niak.
I went Luke Freeman as well.
Hawko?
Freeman.
And the answer is Luke Freeman.
He'll play for Luton.
He's a fruit agent.
He can play as QPR, don't he?
23. Who was the oldest player to make a first-team appearance for Jules?
The oldest player?
Oh.
Oh, I think I know this one.
Oh, and Luke Freeman was 15 years and 233 days at that appearance, so he wasn't even 16 yet.
You know who I mean when I've just sent that answer, Kyle? When I spoke
the
name right.
I do know who you mean.
Yeah.
Okay. Owen, who do you think?
Well, as those are people that come to mind, but considering that he's turned 40 like yesterday, I'd say probably Glenn Morris, isn't it?
Cool. Hawko, who do you think?
Mr. Lee.
Okay. Alex?
I put Burton, but now I feel like it's Nels.
Okay. Beth?
I put a stupid answer again. I've just put Danny Kedwell.
Yeah, I think it's time for everyone to pull one out because the answer is actually Andy Hessenthaler.
Oh, come on. I mean, I got to do two.
How old was he?
40 years and 115 days.
Owen's not even drinking.
Nah, I'm driving.
Hang on a minute. True. With what car?
That's got me double for James. If I'm doing double for Beth, that's double for James. Hold your boy up, son.
I'm not responsible for him.
I'm usually taxi driver, to be honest.
No, Carl is. Or John on yesterday's occasion.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, John. In the 2012-13 title-winning season, who was our top scorer and how many league goals did they score? I'll give you 1 point for getting it right, 1 point for getting how many goals they scored.
Top goal scorer. Surely it was him. Weren't a lot, though.
Okay, Owen, who do you reckon? And how many?
It's between one and two, isn't it? But because of the penalties, so Kedwell and 12.
Hawke?
Kedwell and 14.
Beth?
I went Kedwell and 12.
Owen? Oh, I've already done Owen. Alex?
Kedwell and 16.
Okay, we have one correct answer. Well, you're all right, it is Kedwell, but one person's getting 2 points, and that's Hawke, because the answer is 14. Burton scored 12 that season. So it's quite close between those two, and then it fell off quite a bit from that point. And question 25. What is the highest squad number that a first team player has appeared in? So number on the back of their shirt. There's two players that have played in this shirt, and if you get the number and both players, you can have 3 points. God knows Alex needs them.
Thanks. I've only got an idea on one of the players if it's this number, but that makes me think it's wrong.
I think it was in the winning season. Oh, but I can't remember the numbers. Oh. I don't know how to spell his surname either. He might be one. But I can't think of the other one.
You want to guess a number, Hawko? You haven't put a squad number down. Cool. Right, Owen, what do you reckon?
I can't give you any players, but I'd guess 45.
Cool. Not the one that's wearing 45 now.
Who's that?
Like Alex knows.
I don't know. He had a 45.
Oh, no!
Oh, boys, come on!
No!
I've had a stinker here.
He's literally in our current squad. For God's sake.
So Alex has guessed 45 and 45.
My God.
Hawko's gone with Nathan Nyathley at 38. And Beth? Beth, you just put 38, but no player.
Yeah, no player's just 38.
But sorry to piss on your cornflakes, Alex, but it's still not right. The answer is 50. And
hey, I'm okay with it.
We've had J. Emmanuel Thomas and Deji Oshalaja both wear that shirt.
I'm okay with it. I think James and Owen drink for not knowing Macaulay Bond wears number 45.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. I wholeheartedly agree with that.
Shocking. It's absolute shocking. I can't believe that.
26.
I don't know what it was. It was the fact of.
Go on.
Owen mentioned about driving, and then I had pictures of Bond in the wall on Woodland Road. And it all got out of control.
What is the most
Newcastle
that we have played a team in the Scally and post-Scally era in a single season, and who was it? So there's 2 points again. The most times we've played a team in a season in competitive matches, so pre-season games don't count. And what team was it?
I think I might have got that.
Got no chance.
Still have nightmares about him.
Oh, you'll hear more about that soon, don't worry. Owen, what do you reckon?
I hazard a guess at Wimbledon.
How many times do you reckon?
Oh, shit, no. I mean, no, I know now. Can I change it?
No, but you can guess the number. Because you didn't say that.
Five.
Okay. Hawko, what's your guess?
Bristol City, four times.
Alex?
I put Cheltenham, four.
And Beth?
I went for Bristol Rovers, four.
Well, Owen was right with a number, it's five times. And Hawko was right with the team, it's Bristol City, not Bristol Rovers.
Dinker.
I'll take a point. Please.
And following on from that, Matt Smith played for them that season. How many goals did he score against us across those five matches?
Go ahead, Matt.
Okay, Owen, how many do you reckon?
Seven.
Alex?
Seven.
Beth?
Seven.
Hawko? Yeah, the answer's seven. He scored two in the league at Ashton Gate, one in the EFL Trophy at Ashton Gate, and four at Priestfield in the EFL Trophy.
Best forms I've ever seen from an individual player.
He always knows how to turn up against us, doesn't he?
A ridiculous forward.
Okay, 28. Jimmy Scarfe scored a hat-trick for us in 1952, and it was a Football League record for the fastest hat-trick until 2004. That doesn't matter, but how quickly did he score it? So the time between his first goal hitting the back of the net and his third goal hitting the back of the net. Whoever's closest gets a point. If you're spot on, you can have five.
Whoa!
I would measure it in minutes points. And seconds, by the way.
Oh, really? I'd put seconds in, do I?
Yeah, you can. I don't think it will help you.
All right, don't worry about it.
Okay, Owen, how quickly do you reckon it was?
Eight minutes and 27 seconds.
Okay. Hawko, do you want to pour a drink and then tell us what your answer was?
It's a drink, 13 minutes.
Alex?
I put 2 minutes and 32 seconds.
Beth?
I went 2 minutes 43 seconds.
You said 2 okay. minutes?
So the answer is 2 minutes 31. So Alex was 1 second out, so how many points do we want to give him?
How do you score 3 goals in 2.5 minutes?
So I said the time between his first goal hitting the back of the net and his third goal hitting the back of the net. It's not time from the game starting.
Alex listened to the question. Alex and Beth listened to the question and we didn't.
That's got to be 2 points.
I think two points.
That's got to be two.
Think he needs all
points. 2 points is fair for hitting the post. He's still a long way off. In the 2019-20 season, who was our top scorer in the league with 6 goals? This season ended early because of COVID, so there was only 35 league games.
All right.
It's
a good bloody question. I don't know. 6 goals. I have not even been at the club.
Okay.
I always eat at the
Owen,
club.
Who do you think?
Ollie Lee.
Beth?
Gone for John Akinde.
Hawkeye?
Dane Oliver.
Alex?
Big for Dane Oliver.
The answer is actually, and I forgot he ever played for us, Alex Jakubiak.
Oh my god.
Wow. Okay.
He's played for us, but yeah, six goals, top scorer in a 35-game season. It's pretty rough, isn't it? It's pretty rough.
It's a fantastic record.
We didn't play 35 games, did we?
We played 35 league games, yeah. We got to the end of February. Okay, question 30. I'm going to set a stopwatch for 30 seconds. Spam my chat, or Owen Fink. Just name a player who got more red cards than yellow cards in their time with us. Get as many points as you got right question, right answers.
How many players?
There's eight in total. So just throw names. Oh, seven. Sorry, not eight.
Three dirty players for us. God.
No, sir.
Okay, oh, he's got to be up there. Now.
Definitely got to be up there. I can only think of four.
Okay. Let's wait for Hawker to send it.
There we go.
Right. Owen, do you want to run through some names?
It's probably all wrong, but Duncan Chapp, Nicky Southall, Danny Jackman, Deji Oshalaja, Bradley Dack, and I'll throw in a... Danny Spiller.
Okay. Hawker, do you want to go through your list that you sent me?
I've gone Steve Lomas, Ollie Lee, Paul Smith, Andy Hesenthal, and John Nutter.
Okay. Alex, I've got one from you.
I only said one, and it was Minoga.
Okay. And Beth?
I said the same as Alex, and then I said Steve Evans, I'm not sure if I'm counting managers as well, Charlie Kelman, and Mark McCallum.
Okay, unfortunately, no one got it right, got any of them. But the list of seven I've got is Zesh Raymond, Tom Flanagan, Callum Davis, Sean Clarcy, Simon Royce, Kevin James, and Roland Edge.
Absolutely brilliant.
In his time with us, he only got... Simon Royce obviously made a couple hundred appearances, I think. He got one red and no yellows. Okay, I'm going to go on to a little bit of pictures now. So I'm going to disappear. Footballer here. First person to guess who it is gets the point.
I can't actually see it. I can't see it.
It's meant to be blurry, that's the point.
Oh, but I can't see it at all. I can't
see the stream at all.
Has the stream gone?
I can see it.
I can see it.
My stream's gone, yeah.
Mine's loading, but I don't know if it's actually going to load.
Loading, yeah.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Right, can't so we'll start off. Do any of you think you have a good guess as to who this is?
Sort of.
No. You could just say it. First person to get it right out loud gets the point, and then we move on.
DJ Samuel, the left back.
Okay. Anyone else got a guess?
No, because I can't see it, so...
Alex, Beth, got nothing?
Nothing, mate. No, absolutely nothing.
Okay, we'll clear it up a little bit. Does that help?
No. I guess it's not JJ Samuel.
It's not, no.
Right.
I mean, from the shirt, I'm going to guess this was like, what, 2003, 2004 kind of time?
Yep.
So it's...
I was like 4.
3-year-old. Yeah.
No, I'm on Nosworthy.
Nope. Does that help more?
No.
That's quite some of I was faced there.
Neil Harris.
Could be. Drink. Could be. It's not low. Okay. That's as clear as it gets. Because this is not pixelated anymore. No idea, anyone?
Not a clue, man.
Kevin Lisby.
No, it's Patrick Adjumang.
Can't see it, so.
Well, I mean, you're in the lead. It gives everyone a chance to catch up to you.
Which
okay, next one. Anyone think they know who this is?
Egan?
Brennan Dickinson.
Yeah, Owen's actually got it right.
Go on,
Brennan Dickinson.
That doesn't get you a point if you're too late, Hawko. Worth a try, though. Okay, third one.
Luke O'Neill.
Any other guesses? Luke O'Neill's not right.
Alex Basu.
Yep.
Come
on, Owen, son.
Reese would have got that 10 minutes before it come up.
Who do we think this is?
Dave Bruce.
No.
That's all I got for that sort of error.
Yeah, not clear.
I'll make it a bit clearer. I assure you it's still not Steve Bruce.
Are we sure? Yeah, not clear.
Deep Hawak in Yemi.
No. Okay, that's as clear as it gets. No idea, anyone?
No, I've got nothing.
The answer is Steve Lovell. Okay, last one.
Matt Jarvis.
Nope.
No way is that not Matt Jarvis, by the way.
It's not.
I can't tell what sort.
Don't agree with it. Yeah, that. Yeah, I'll check that.
Does it still look like him to you now?
Ben Nugent.
Yep. Owen's crushed this round, hasn't he? Okay, we're on to the final five questions. I will hide that now. You get me again. And Hawker, have you still not got your screen share working? Because the last bit's anagrams, and it'd probably help if you can see it.
I can't actually see it at all. So if there's any way I can join on my phone,
it'd be you have to join helpful. The chat on your phone.
It's not
gonna,
coming
it's
up.
It's going to mess up where all the screens are, though.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll read them out. I'll read them out and I'll send it in a message to you as well. So you can read the message.
Yeah, that will be helpful. Thank you, mate.
Okay, so the first anagram. So these are all Jules players, the anagrams. Start with an easy one. Just send it back in the chat to me.
Okay.
What, is that a hint or an anagram?
That's an anagram.
Because we've had a lot of them.
That's an anagram.
Oh, right.
So can't actually see it because my answer might be stupid.
Oh.
No. Hawko, it's not a hint, it's an anagram. So you've got to rearrange those letters to get a player.
Can't see the letters, though. That's
no,
the
I just sent it to you on the message. It's above it.
Oh, there we go. Right, okay.
Okay, Owen, who do you reckon it is?
Max Aimer.
Alex?
Max Aimer.
Beth?
Max Aimer.
Hawko?
Max Aimer.
You sure it's not Ollie Lee?
Oh, it's not Ollie Lee.
Okay, good. Right, well, you've all got it right. Congrats. I will get the next one up for you.
Is it current players, or is it just like any past and present?
Current and past.
Okay.
So yeah, it could be.
Oh, yeah.
The pool of players was quite limited because it was quite hard to find an anagram that was actually two real words.
I have no idea who that is.
Do you know it, Owen?
Okay.
No clue. No.
Okay, so we all... Doesn't look like anyone else has got it right. So the answer for that is Julian Lewis.
Who?
Julian Lewis.
Who's that?
Junior Lewis. Sorry, he set up Junior the playoff
Lewis.
Final one.
Reed. Junior Lewis. This one I'll send to you, Hawko. This player has come up as an answer in this quiz before, if that helps.
What?
No one got an idea? You got anything, Owen?
No.
Right, the answer to this one was Nicky Southall.
I thought that, but I couldn't work it out.
Question 39 is on the screen.
Oh.
He's played for us quite recently. Got any ideas, Owen?
No, not yet.
Give you another 10 seconds. Nothing?
No.
Okay, Hawko guessed Zach Medley, which isn't quite right. The answer for this one's
good
Carl.
Guess, to be fair.
It's Carl Dempsey. And the final question, I don't expect anyone to get this, but it was quite hard to get anagrams of players that were real words.
God.
Anyone?
No.
Alex can say his answer out loud if he wants.
The 1893 show.
It's not right. The answer.
Is he going to say clue in terms of error?
Oh, God. He played for Jills between 2001 and 2006. And made 58 appearances in that time.
Right, skip.
No.
It's skip, no. Fair enough. It's Richard Rose. Didn't expect anyone to get that. And the final question, which I haven't written down on the screen, but I'm going to chuck this in. 3 points for getting it right. To the nearest second, what time did the floodlights go out in the game against Leyton Orient last season?
Was it that?
Okay, Owen, what do you reckon?
78-12.
Cool. Beth?
I went for 78-24.
Oh, come on.
Alex?
81-03.
And Hawko?
Oh, I've gone 64 minutes, 30 seconds, but it's not that.
No, the correct answer is 79 minutes and 14 seconds. So Beth was just about closest. And by these completely bullshit rules that I've just made up, Beth wins the quiz.
Come on, up the 1893.
Come on. Yeah, thanks, Alex. You did nothing to help the team.
Less of that.
That's it. Well, I guess MB7 wins on an aggregate victory, so everyone wins in a way, apart from Alex, who just loses.
Oh! Yeah, I'll take it.
Okay, thank you very much to everyone for watching, and we'll be back next week with a football-based challenge. See you later.